it'll be more of a give and take as it was with Ray Mercer and Bert Cooper. Then there are lots of heavyweight fights out there that don't involve Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield, and George Foreman that they can engage in that don't involve any kind of a title.
Yeah, and Ray Mercer now and Francesco Damiani, who are still to come, have to take a look at this fight and say, wait a minute, this is supposed to be our showcase, and right now it's a couple of other guys who are making the news. Now, Francesco Damiani, who is not incidentally the winner of the Jerry Cooney lookalike contest.
But
in,
close.
Yes. In his dressing room warming up and trying to get loose for his encounter with Ray Mercer. And again, both the people that preceded him that won have looked very impressive, and I think the onus is even more on these two guys now.
It probably is, because they're the ones that are presumably much closer to the major, major fight. Of course, they're fighting for a WBO heavyweight title. And yes, it's like following a great entertainment act, right?
Yeah,
the guy in front of you opens great, you better be good.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And that's what has happened so far. So tonight, it's Damiani and Mercer who are theoretically selling tickets, but you have an idea it's Morrison and Seldon who might be selling them the next time around. Well, we'll remind you that there's more boxing coming your way in April. Top Rank, in conjunction with Main Events, will present the Heavyweight Championship of the World. That's coming up in April.
April 19th, live from Trump Plaza in Atlantic City, TVKO invites you to witness the Battle of the Ages. Evander Holyfield versus George Foreman. Evander Holyfield, 25-0, 21 knockouts, the undefeated heavyweight champion of the world.
Hard punches have got Jameis rocking.
Can George Foreman accomplish one of the most spectacular comebacks in the history of the ring? Foreman is 24-0 on his comeback trail with 23 KOs, and he's trimming down. Holyfield's bulking up.
There, he's hurt badly by a body shot.
Don't miss it. Coming to you on pay-per-view April 19th, TVKO presents the Heavyweight Championship of the World. Evander Holyfield takes on George Foreman in the Battle of the Ages. Don't miss it. April 19th on pay-per-view.
And so we come now to the main event, and that main event between Ray Mercer and Francesco Damiani. And we were talking about what we might say to one another at this segment of the show, and I think what we were going to talk about is the fact that the winner of this fight has to not only win but be impressive. And I think based on what we have already seen, that's even more true for these two now than it was before the fight started.
Yeah, I think it is, because what we have is two boxers amazingly fighting for the WBO title who are kind of having their coming out party and getting it rather late. Francesco Damiani getting it at the age of 32, because he stayed amateur for a long time and was also fighting in Europe. For Ray Mercer at 29, he is getting a late party because he was an amateur and had to wade his way through some of the pros in the last year and a half. Very important for them to be impressive.
One word that I think is going to be very important for both fighters, that word is jab. Whoever can do it is likely to win it.
And for Ray Mercer especially, he keeps Damiani on the end of the jab. He wins this fight.
Well, it's interesting, too. I think that these two guys almost are mirror images of one another. We talked about the fact that they were both Olympians. Damiani in 1980 and 1984. Mercer in 1988. They both had one impressive victory. Tonight, one of them will stand apart from the other one. Will it be Damiani or Mercer?
In 88, during the Olympic year, I just said, I'm going to take, you know, one step at a time, one fight at a time. And everything, I was training hard as I could, and everything was like coming easy. I was over there for a week, and I still was trying to convince myself that I was, you know, I was on an Olympic team, and I'm over here in the Olympics. I couldn't believe it. It was a dream of mine to make the Olympic team. And, you know, making it and doing the best I can do, and that being enough, representing every American in the world, you know, I was just so proud. I really didn't start believing until after, you know, they threw the gold medal around my neck, and that's when I knew, you know, that everything was for real. Like, it's no dream. It's, you know, you can't describe a feeling like that, but it's something that nobody can ever take from you. And I think it's a feeling that you would never experience again. So I'm always gonna cherish that.
When you fight in a tournament for the world title, your immediate goal is to get to the final. So you have a lot of opponents to beat. Stevens clearly was a legend at that time in amateur boxing. He was the top. And to beat him was a major, major accomplishment, and made me really very happy. Of course, that was a turning point in my career. Naturally, the victory opened a lot of doors for me and made me famous worldwide. I was an amateur fighter for 2 more years after that. And the success that followed allowed me to enter professional fighting with a positive attitude.
Damiani is undefeated since turning professional. While rising through the ranks of the heavyweight division, he avenged himself against a nemesis from his amateur days, the former Olympic gold medalist Tyrell Biggs. While campaigning in Europe, the Italian heavyweight captured the WBO World Heavyweight title. Even though this title was not the true world championship, it placed him in the heavyweight fast lane with a chance at the big time.
I think I'm one of the best. That's what others say, one of the best heavyweights.
At age 27, Ray Mercer debuted as a pro. He demonstrated heavyweight power, but his raw talent needed to be refined. And he showed one other thing, the reason why they call him Merciless Ray. The former Army sergeant had declared war on the heavyweights. 2 years later, Ray Mercer has honed his skills and become a top contender.
I started boxing in the Army, so the Army, to me, deserves all the credit. And being a good soldier, such as, I was a good soldier, and that's how, I got to box or whatever. They teach you discipline, really, and they teach you responsibility, they teach you it's like in the Army, you go to war, you don't get but one chance. So that's the attitude that I have now.
Both Mercer and Damiani can envision the end of their respective rainbows. They're both looking for the same pot of gold. But only the victor will be close enough to reach for boxing's most coveted prize.
He makes me very happy because it's a great honor to be able to fight in this country. It's a fact that this is the capital of boxing. I hope to do well and come back here to fight, maybe with Tyson or Holyfield or whoever will be the world champion then.
If I keep doing what I'm doing now, you just have to really wait your turn, And I'm going to get that shot because there's been guys, sorry guys out there getting shots. They probably know they can't win. It's going to take a little longer for me because people out there know I can win. And when I get in there, I'm going to give everything I got. It's going to be like the old days where the gladiators used to battle and only one came out alive. And I know that's what kind of fight it's going to be when I fight for the title. Regardless of who I fight, I'm going in with the attitude just like that.
So the words have been spoken. Let's take a look at what the numbers say to us, Al.
Tale of the tape tells us that the big difference there, I think, is the fact that Mercer's weight is really perfect at 215. Damiani may be carrying a little too much.
Damiani fighting in the United States for only the fourth to fifth time, I should say. He has won all four previous fights, all by knockout. He has 23 knockouts, and yet people are saying he's not really a knockout puncher. Let's talk about the WBO rules and how they differ.
Yeah, the big difference is there is no standing eight count here. And the rest are pretty much the same as New Jersey, but no standing eight count.
So the battle of the undefeateds, Ray Mercer and Francesco Damiani. Mercer being rushed along toward what he hopes will be a title shot. He's only had 16 professional fights. His last one was the most impressive, and Francesco Damiani in the United States for the fifth time, starting to make his way, as Ray Mercer now making his way toward the ring. Mercer, remember, is the challenger, and Damiani the champion, albeit not a coveted title, really, but nonetheless a title, and as such, a stepping stone.
And Ray Mercer should get quite a reaction from this New Jersey crowd. He trains in New Jersey and the Triple Threat Gym, and has a great following here. Visual as well.
Looking all business, if that's a description of how someone looks.
Well, he's faced pressure like this before. The Olympic Games, about as pressure-packed as you can get.
Carrying a sign in support of the troops in the Middle East.
Of course, as we've noted, and as you saw, he was in the Army, and that's where he got his start boxing. Some wondering if he'd be to this point this quick, but he's there, and now the question is for him, can he produce?
Well, and the question was, before his last fight, is he tough enough, mentally tough enough, as opposed to physically tough enough? And I think he answered all those questions against Britt Cooper, because he was hurt.
And he was hurt in that fight, and defending in that bout the NABF title, and you saw held aloft there a moment ago. Signs of support all over here for Ray Mercer.
Very, very popular figure in this part of the country, all through the state of New Jersey. And Francesco Damiani certainly will feel like a lonely man tonight.
It's ironic that he's coming into the strains of Rocky. He's the champion, isn't he?
Sort of Rocco.
I guess the Italian stallion connection were as at work there.
People have talked about Damiani for a long time, but he is a classic example of a guy who really has not gotten any respect.
And it's because he has been something of a mystery man here in America. These fans get a glimpse of him, and you watching get a glimpse of him. It's one of those situations where you're not sure what to expect from Damiani. Some tapes have been seen. He's an aggressive kind of a fighter, awkward. And he's got the WBO belt, so everybody's got a belt in there, but his is the one that Ray Mercer really wants right now.
And that, he hopes, will lead to another belt. So Damiani with some fan support, as you see. And you look at the WBO championship belt being held aloft by Damiani's people.
You know, there is a sense, I'm watching this, I have a sense of anticipation about Francesco Damiani to see what he's got to offer.
Yeah, the unknown, he really is that. I saw him on a card several years ago. He was on an undercard of a Larry Holmes fight. He wound up winning the fight. It wasn't in tremendously impressive fashion, but that may have just been the opponent. Let's make it official now and beat him with Michael Buffett.
Ladies and gentlemen, Top Rank Incorporated and the undisputed, undefeated King of Beer, Budweiser, present the featured bout of the evening. This bout is approved by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, Boxing Commissioner Larry Hazard Sr., Chairman Jerry Gormley, Board Members Gary Shaw and Richard Harrison, Deputy Commissioners Lawrence Wallace and R. Yogi Hiltner, Chief Physician at ringside, Dr. Frank B. Doggett, Attending Physicians, Dr. Dominic Coletta Jr. and Dr. Charles Wilson. This bout is sanctioned by the World Boxing Organization, represented at ringside by its Championship Committee Director, Mr. Ed Levine, and WBO Supervisor ringside, First Vice President Jose Torres. The three judges assigned to this bout, doing the scoring on a 10-point must system, will be Eva Shain from the United States, Nelson Vazquez from Puerto Rico, and Harry Davis of Canada. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Donald J. Trump's Taj Mahal on the boardwalk here in Atlantic City, New Jersey, let's get ready to rumble. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO World Heavyweight Championship. In the ring at this time, the man in charge of this bout, referee Rudy Battle. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black trunks with Project Pride trim. He weighs an even 215 pounds. originally from Jacksonville, Florida, now fighting for the Triple Threat Gym in Newark, New Jersey. This nine-year U.S. Army veteran won Olympic gold in 1988, now as a professional. He's 16-0 with 11 KOs and currently holds the NABF title and the IBF Intercontinental Heavyweight title. Ranked number 4 in the world by the IBF, tonight he challenges for a world title. Ladies and gentlemen, the undefeated Merciless, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, weighing in at 229 and one quarter pounds in the black trunks with gold trim. He's from Rimini, Italia. This 1984 Olympic silver medalist now has a professional record of 27-0. 23 of his 27 victories by knockout, presenting the undefeated WBO heavyweight world champion, Francesco
Okay, gentlemen, you've received your pre-fight instructions. Let's have a nice, clean fight. Good luck to both of you. Shake hands.
So what's left is to get on with it. And both fighters looking like they could be a little bit nervous. This is going to be a case, I think, to get a couple of punches thrown, settle down, settle into the fight, and then see what happens.
And if there's anyone that I think is more susceptible early, it's probably Damiani, because Mercer is the bigger puncher. If he were to land something very big early, we might have a big shock in Damiani going out early.
And you talked about the fact that Damiani might be carrying a little extra poundage, and in all honesty, he looks a little bit soft is the word that comes to mind.
Of course, it's tough to judge. I say that, and I think it's true, but he's always been that way, so maybe it's always been a problem.
Well, again, we talk about the fact that the jab is really key in this, and Damiani's history, good left hand by Mercer. Broke Damiani backwards, but did not seem to hurt him.
But I assure you, Damiani has not faced a puncher like Ray Mercer. As you look down the list of his opponents, there's no one who punches as hard as Ray Mercer in that group, so he'll feel something different tonight.
To emphasize the point about the jab, Damiani's history is that when he is effective with his jab, he does well. But when the other man is effective with his, it takes Damiani's jab away.
And that is what they want Ray Mercer to do in this bout now. Already early, he's kind of ignoring that. And I think, you know, one of the worst things to happen for him may be landing those big left hooks early. It could make him think, I've got to load up, I'll knock him out with one punch. That's been Ray's problem from time to time. They want that stick out there. They want that jab to keep Damiani from doing this, Barry, getting inside where he can throw his little short combinations.
Both fighters a little bit off the mark early.
Damiani will work the body, as will Mercer. Both men are committed to that. There's Mercer digging low.
And if, in fact, Damiani is, as we suspect, perhaps a little soft, body shots are going to tell that.
Mercer is really digging down there as well.
All right, break. Turn loose. Let him go. Step out. Step out.
This is really a good test for both these men.
It is. They're at the level where they should be fighting each other. Damiani's jab, non-effective so far. Mercer's hasn't been that much better, but Ray's been getting there with bigger power shots so far.
All right, break.
If we're into things like common opponents, there has only been one, Eddie Richardson, who Damiani beat in 10 rounds back in 1987, and Mercer fought 2 years later and knocked out in one round.
And that really is a good indication of where their power is. Damiani, the kind of guy that wins against anybody that's a little better, will win a decision more than likely.
Mercer doing more than Damiani in this first round. Quick right hand by Damiani.
That's as good a right hand as Damiani can throw, straight.
Right, on him.
End of the first round, and as we suspect, expected largely a feeling out round. Perhaps a little bit better for Ray Mercer than it was for Damiani, but neither man dominated.
What do you want there?
Okay, I know. You just, but I'll, that way you don't get tired, okay? Yeah. Now, work the body more. More. I need you jabbing more, right hand to the body, hook to the body, hook to the head.
Work the jab more, work the body more. Okay, buddy.
You be first. You stay in charge.
Sit.
Now, don't step around him. Step to him straight to him. Step around him just a little bit. Okay? Work the jab more, work the body more. Hook to the body, hook to the head.
All right.
We got time. We got plenty of that.
Excellent advice.
Okay, let's go. 2 seconds out. Copies, Tommy. Let's go.
Oh, we talked about the jab being a weapon, and Mercer not using it a great deal in the first round.
12 of 29 jabs. He landed 47%. Damiani only 8 of 27. 30% landed with the jabs. Excellent advice from Hank Johnson. The jab and those body shots are what will probably get him there, Ray Mercer. The body especially. He really did hurt him to the body. There you see from the punch profile, the numbers, and Ray Mercer with a very good percentage landed.
He needs to throw at least that many jabs. But once again, Damiani's history is that when somebody throws more than 35 jabs in a round, then they can take Damiani's jab away from him. But when they throw less than that, Damiani can be effective. That's at least coming into this fight. That's what Damiani has done.
And what Damiani does with his jab, Barry, is it's not even that he's always landing. It helps him get inside where he can then throw these little... See, that's where... That jab got him in, so now he's on the inside. He can throw his little shots.
Fight being fought at close range, which it almost seems would favor Damiani.
When he gets in there, I think it would. And some believe that by letting Ray Cooper get closer to him, Ray Mercer made it a tougher fight. Although there's some good shots from outside for Damiani. So after a lackluster first round, Damiani is finding the range now.
Really not much there. Mercer really was chasing Damiani after Damiani got a right hand in fairly close.
And very amateurish move by Ray Mercer. And that's, of course, what they don't like to see from him. He is laying the jab out there, though, Mercer. That's why Damiani is getting in with those counterpunches. Ray is laying the jab out, and Francesco getting in with his counterpunches.
We will be going into Damiani's corner between rounds, and we'll tell you we have an interpreter there to tell us exactly what's being said. Ciro Santini alongside to interpret in the corner of Francesco Damiani.
This is the second round that Damiani wanted, and Mercer didn't, because Damiani is making things happen because Ray Mercer has gotten away from his battle plan, and he is wild in this round. And this round could be a very big confidence builder for Francesco Damiani. He needed it after the first round here in alien territory.
Yeah, he's fighting right now like a much more confident fighter, and he got there with a combination. Not real damaging, but nonetheless, they were there. Time running out in round two, and a much better round for Damiani. And this fight shaping up as a very tactical one.
Okay.
Olha que vai fuori dal destro.
Nuove più facili from the right punch. You have to get inside
with your both corners. I don't want any hitting on the break. You tell him. You know? Clean break. You speak.
Molto pulito nel break.
Molto pulito nel break. Non picchiare dopo.
You have to get clean when the referee called the break.
Determinazione voglio. Più determinazione. Non le regge le 12 ripetizioni.
Determination. Determination.
Se dai la possibilità di recupero. Quello lo fa, eh?
You have to recuperate.
So seemingly a little bit more of a pep talk than a strategy talk in the corner of Damiani.
Much more so, though, the one thing they did say was to get inside on Ray Mercer, which he's been doing pretty effectively.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad round at all for Damiani.
No, that's what they want.
In that second round, Mercer threw 33 jabs, only landed 8 of them, though, and Damiani at 50%, 14 of 28.
And there you see the total numbers in round two. Damiani moving ahead in that round, landing a good percentage of his punches. Ray Mercer is not only missing the jab, he's throwing it with no conviction. None whatsoever. That one was better than some of the others he's thrown. He was kind of backing off with that.
Yeah, he was really just showing it to him, and it got there.
And what happened to the body punches that Hank Johnson was asking him for? I'm not sure Francesco Damiani didn't get a little respect from Ray Mercer in that second round. Good hook by Damiani. And the body work.
Damiani really fighting like a confident fighter right now, and Mercer fighting like a guy who really hasn't quite figured out what's going on in there yet.
And you know, in the first round, Ray Mercer landed those good left hooks and hasn't been able to reproduce that.
You know, there's another factor, too, in the fight against Burt Cooper. Burt Cooper really busted Ray Mercer up in that fight, and this is the first fight that Mercer has had since then. And that can play hell with your mind, I would think.
It was a tough battle for Mercer. And you're right, it could have some residual effects. Gotta like the way Damiani's working the body. He is throwing good shots with good leverage down there. And his jab works him in. There's the jab that gets Damiani in this kind of punching position, which he likes.
And Damiani actually got the better of that exchange with a right hand. That right hand by Mercer over the top of the head of Damiani.
Damiani is beating Ray Mercer to the punch right now, showing better hand speed than some would have given him credit for. It's a cliche word, but crafty applies for Damiani. Straight punches, much straighter than I've seen in the tapes I've seen or when I've seen them on the undercards from Damiani. Much straighter punches.
And he got Mercer turned around once again. He's been doing that with some regularity.
All right, great. Let him go.
Boy, your point is well taken about hand speed. Damiani clearly beating Mercer to the punch right now.
And these are not straight punches coming from Ray Mercer at all.
Nice left hand by Damiani, and a big round for Damiani. Excellent round for Damiani. Now, in Mercer's corner, you heard Hank Johnson say you got to get off first, but I don't think it's so much that you have to get off first. You got to get off best.
Somewhat accurately. Round four, and the first two of the first three have been rounds that Francesco Damiani would like to press in his memory book. I mean, yeah. They were nice.
Starts out this way, a right hand and two left hands behind it. And when Mercer does throw punches, he's lunging, he's not really on balance.
Already showing signs of being, I don't want to use the word desperate, but it almost feels that way. After what for him was a very nice first round. See, he's missing to the body and missing to the head. The accuracy of Ray Mercer, not good. And there, look, he turns to the referee. Could have been nailed.
nice and clean.
Another thing Mercer is doing on occasion is almost winding up with his punches. It's really, here it comes.
Mercer has an Olympic gold medal and Francesco Damiani doesn't, but Francesco Damiani has got that WBO title and also he's got things going his way tonight so far.
Definitely since the first round.
Now there's the good body work by Mercer on the inside.
Nice uppercut by Mercer.
And look what it set up for him. This is what Mercer should be doing, but boy, Francesco Damiani doesn't back up an inch, does he? Fascinating. Strong jab by Mercer, wow. Now that's what they want from him. He's got a punishing jab.
Watch your hands, watch your hands.
And that uppercut starting to find a home for Mercer also.
It's very simple. Ray Mercer's throwing now. He wasn't throwing with conviction for a couple of rounds. He's paying the price sometimes.
Damiani again there quicker.
Ray Mercer does not fight that well on the inside. He really doesn't. And he's paid for it against Bert Cooper, against Jerry Jones in a fight we did. He's paying for it right now against Damiani.
Nice combination. Three-punch combination by Damiani. And Mercer misses with a left hand in return. Damiani's just sharper right now.
All right, Frank, let him go. Come on.
There's a little swelling under the left eye of Ray Mercer, and he really did swell up after the Bert Cooper fight.
Get this tape.
Sei forte. Non c'è problema nel match. Hey, non c'è problema.
You are very strong. You are too strong. You don't have no problem to beat him.
Lì, guardami. Cerca di essere convinto quello che fai. L'uomo è tutto lì, forse anche meno se
go with more conviction inside.
Hai capito?
More determination.
Non c'è determinazione in quello che fai. Devi essere più convinto in quello che
go
fai.
Go with more determination.
Hai capito, no, eh?
Deep breath, deep breath. Deep, deep.
Hold still. Hold still.
We start the fifth round. And Ray Mercer is going to have to figure out something here.
One of the things he might figure out is throwing more jabs. He only threw 16 in the last round. The reason we're harping on this is because traditionally people have done better against Damiani when they jab against him. And of those jabs he landed in the last few rounds, they were strong by Mercer. To win this bout, unless something really changes radically, Ray Mercer's gonna have to make this an alley brawl and hope that his power wins out. But you know what? When he gets in those big exchanges with Damiani, he's getting nailed too.
Yeah, Damiani, clearly the crisper puncher, the sharper puncher, even when they're in an exchange. That's not to say that that can't change, but Damiani just seems to have Mercer measured better.
Damiani throwing much better combinations. And again, there's the jab. Even if it's not landing, it's getting him in very good punching position.
Nice right hand uppercut by Damiani.
That came, that came from way back, and it shows you that Ray Mercer's reflexes in it tonight are not really as sharp as they might be.
And again, a little swelling. In fact, it's more than a little swelling under the left eye of Ray Mercer. That is the kind of swelling that could really cause him a problem as this fight goes on. An uppercut behind it.
And Damiani giving Mercer just enough movement, Jerry. He's not running around the ring, just enough to, so that Mercer can't quite get the right punching angles on him.
And you know something? Americans have been kidding about Francesco Damiani for the last year or so. They've been kidding about him with his WBO title. He may have come here to prove something.
Well, so far he's certainly doing that. He's a different fighter than the last time I saw him.
Yeah, different than any time I've seen him either.
And that could go back to the old thing, too, if some fighters just fight to the caliber of their competition. The last time I saw him, it was against an inferior opponent, and here he is against a guy who theoretically at least is an up-and-comer, and he's fighting much better. Mercer's shot was caught on the gloves, and Damiani connected with two.
Mercer landed those left hooks in the first round. Since then, they have not been there. He's been throwing them from too far out, and Damiani keeping his hands up very well.
And there may be a little bit of a cut along the right eye of Mercer. We'll watch that. I can't quite tell if it's perspiration or cut. And those are Damiani supporters right there.
Come on now. Come on, you gotta wake up.
And there is a little nick,
now
as you see. Percy Richardson working on that over the right eye, but it's really the left eye that's more of a problem for Ray Mercer, because there is some swelling underneath that, as you see.
Damiani has shown us in this fight that he can put punches together very well. The right, a much straighter punch than we've seen, and look, right away he's coming with the uppercut on the inside. That's a good right hand. We'll see an uppercut that did land. This one from way out. There. Now, you're not supposed to let a guy land that. He's not supposed to be able to throw it from that far out and land as cleanly as he did against Ray Mercer.
And we talked about the fact that what Damiani was getting in his corner four were pep talks, and that's certainly what he's getting now, and why not? There is no need to translate any of that. What they're saying is do what you're doing, because you're doing it all right.
And the key word for tonight in that corner is determination, and guess what? Damiani has it.
Round number six. It's called round fight because it is a championship fight, remember?
Interesting. Damiani not that far ahead, though. I've been notching up these rounds for him, but in terms of number of punches, not a huge edge there. So I'm almost surprised at, but, you know, but still, I feel like he's in control of this fight.
You really do have that feeling. But, you know, here again is a situation, and this is not to get on to the officials about this, but sometimes frenetic activity in some people's eyes amounts to points. And Mercer has had the frenetic activity. And there again, a good example of what we're talking about.
Two good shots by Damiani.
All right, great. Let him go. You hold him. Step out.
Again, the straight right hand by Francesco. See, just enough movement to keep Ray Mercer off balance. And when you give Ray Mercer side to side, traditionally, in his pro career, he has had trouble dealing with it.
Let him go.
And Damiani, I am surprised he's been able to give him enough movement to give him trouble, but he has. Look, now maybe two of those five land, but that's more than Mercer's landing.
Break, stop, Quentin. Let him go.
And I don't think too many people thought around the halfway point of this fight it would be taking this shape. Good jab again by Damiani.
Again, it's that old unknown quantity. It's the guy who's fought 22 or 23 of his 27 fights in Italy. And he hasn't fought a high caliber opponent, but by the same token, neither has Ray Mercer.
All right, break. Step out.
Now, the best man Ray fought was Bert Cooper, not too bad a guy.
He fought Ozzy Ocasio, who also falls into the category of trial horse, and he didn't have an easy time with him either.
Well, the problems for Ray started when he fought Jerry Jones, a fight that you and I called, and Jones gave him lots of trouble. He ended up winning. Since then, he's had some problems. He may have hurt Damiani with that right hand.
He hurt him with a body shot is what I think he hurt him with. We'll maybe get a chance to see that again, but I think the body shot is really what set up the right hand.
And they've been calling for body shots, and he has not been able to produce. And now he does. Of course, the power of Mercer is the wild card. That gives him a shot in any fight.
And he has opened Damiani up a couple of times here at the end of this round.
Some angles on him. Box him a little bit, give him a more points, move his jab. Just a little bit, okay?
Here is the body shot that we believe hurt Ray Mercer, or rather Damiani. Right hand downstairs, sent him reeling backwards, and then he started pounding on him with right hands. So Ray Mercer working that body and getting some results. But that's where Damiani looks at his corner and shakes his head like, no, I'm okay. Well, was he? I don't know. We'll find out in this round.
Mercer did open him up a little bit, as we said. So a better sixth round for Ray Mercer, and we move to seventh.
But even so, in that round, I really thought Damiani did much better work.
Round seven scheduled for 12. The fight's still there to be had.
Well, Damiani beat Tyrell Biggs, the man who had beaten him in 1984, beat one gold medalist. He'd like to notch another one tonight.
Incidentally, we talked about a little swelling under the left eye of Ray Mercer about three rounds ago. It has gotten no worse. In fact, if anything, it might even be a little bit better. And that's credit to Percy Richardson in the corner. And as you can see, the total punches in round number six, and Damiani still with a much higher percentage and a higher rate of throwing punches.
Very accurate in that last round. Those are two superb jabs by Damiani. Two elements of this fight plan for Ray Mercer, and they've gone out the window, the jab and the body work. You heard Hank Johnson harping on it. Ray Mercer has either been unwilling or unable to make those two things work.
And Damiani, you touched upon this earlier, that Mercer would like nothing more than to get him into a real brawl, and Damiani's just not allowing himself to get into that.
And even when he does, Damiani is getting some pretty good results, Barry. Mercer's still trying to find that elusive left hook that he was landing so easily in round one. When you looked at round one, you got the feeling Ray Mercer was going to land his power shots easily, and it hasn't happened. And still Damiani working that uppercut on the inside. He discovered that about the second round.
All right, break. We're wrapping. Stop punching.
Damiani walked into the left hand from Mercer that time.
Mercer falling back as he delivers the right hand. Ray Mercer's accuracy is abysmal. I mean, he's missing everything. He's throwing. Just does not look sharp with his punches.
Conversely, Damiani is very sharp. A lot of clashing of the heads going on in this round, too.
When you come to Mercer and punch, he stops. It's been his problem as a pro.
If he doesn't
get off first, he doesn't get off.
Break, come out, let him go, step out, let him go.
I am sure, even though this fight is certainly within Ray Mercer's grasp, there are many raised eyebrows among boxing fans in the boxing community at what is going on here in Atlantic City right now.
Mercer kind of walked away from that, and I think what happened is he might have gotten ahead, actually in his chest. Walked away, took a deep breath, and Rudy Battle never did step between him, so he was fair game.
Hard to see any confidence in Ray Mercer's eyes right now.
Step out, let him go. Hold
on. Going to go into Damiani's corner, and he is fighting like a confident fighter. His fans think their man is ahead. And we'll get the translation in his corner.
How are you doing? Tell me the truth. Don't lie to me. How are you doing? Go faster.
Non è un uomo alla tua portata, lo devi fermare ogni volta che si muove.
Every time you move, you have to stop him.
Hai le capacità per fare queste cose, lo
you
devi
can do
fare.
That.
Tell him to be careful of low blows, okay? Watch the low blows, watch. You speak. Tell him.
And that's not going to get it. I want a combination. Three punch combination.
Bad right hand. Meanwhile, a great Mercer's. I don't think there's exactly panic yet, but there's less than a surety.
We are deep into this bout, and that man
has, I think, won nothing since the first round. And the judges could see it differently, but whatever, Francesco Damiani has, I think, imposed his will on Ray Mercer in this bout.
This fight, of course, being carried live to Italy and all over Europe. Damiani, needless to say, a big local hero in this country.
And as we've said, not a man who has engendered a lot of respect on this side of the Atlantic, but tonight going a long way toward that. And you know, some will denigrate, if he would win, they'll denigrate Ray Mercer and say, oh no, he wasn't that good or whatever. But you know what? He's a good young heavyweight on his way up and close to the top. And if Damiani should continue with a performance like this, take nothing away from him.
Break. Stop punching. Let him go.
Damiani is one of those guys you have a feeling that everybody's going to want to fight because he looks like he should be beatable.
Absolutely.
All right, break. Let him go. Stop punching. Step back.
Well, there was talk of Bruce Seldon being the opponent that would get in against Mercer, perhaps. But, hey, why not against Damiani if he would win? And of course, we're not counting out Ray Mercer by any stretch. He's a powerful young man who, even in the last round, landed a right to body that looked like it hurt Damiani. But Ray had better pick up the gas, step on the gas here.
And again, I hasten to point out that he did have a tough time with Bert Cooper, who cuffed him around a little bit, and he had to suck it up to win in the late round.
That's right.
The bad news here is that Ray Mercer's pushing his punches. And if you're doing that, you're not going to land that big knockout punch. Damiani's punches are a lot crisper right now. And Mercer's going backwards. He's not coming forward. He's not looking like he's a big puncher stalking his prey for the knockout. No.
Well, I think the reason for that is he's earned Damiani's respect. Or Damiani's earned his respect, I should say, because when he has come forward, Damiani's tagged him.
And look at them, and you know, it goes back to the battle of the jabs. You mentioned it at the beginning. Good hook by Damiani. Wow.
Damiani clearly the best of that.
And all those punches by Mercer were pushed punches. He did not get any leverage into it. You can see evidence of a number of things here. One, that Damiani is not a huge puncher. He's landed tremendous shots. Ray Mercer hasn't gone anywhere. Now, Mercer, we've acknowledged, is a tough guy, but still, those are big punches. Hey, Ray Mercer's backing up now. That's not his game. He is not a boxer. He is a slugger. If he keeps backing up, he will never win this fight.
Coming to the end of the eighth round, and Damiani clearly taking control. Tomasi, the best known commentator in Italy, he does everything. Yes. Rino is the man everywhere.
Delightful man and a great commentator. And I'll tell you what, they've got lots to talk about back home because they are watching their man, Francesco Damiani, do a paint job on Ray Mercer, boxing him, using the jab effectively, keeping Mercer at bay and landing shots like that right hand and that left hook. Much quicker on the inside and landing big shots. Those are pretty good shots.
Stay in the corner.
Well, it's interesting. Again, Al, we talked about the jabs and what kind of an effect they would have on the outcome of this fight. Now, both men have thrown the same number of jabs, but
they've both thrown 207, but Damiani has landed 91 and Mercer 54. Where's the mouthpiece of Ray Mercer? That's pretty weird. They forgot to put it in. No, not true. I apologize. It's the glove. Thought maybe the mouthpiece wasn't there.
Okay.
9 seconds had ticked off the clock in that round, so
let's go.
That's where they will pick it up when the battle signals action, and now we're underway again. So 2:51 to go.
And seconds becoming precious to Ray Mercer. He's got 12 minutes. minutes left to make some dramatic things happen.
And he's given no indication that he's going to be able to do that, because anytime he tries to do something dramatic, he actually gets beat. Desperation, even in the cheering of some of the Ray Mercer supporters here, there's starting to be more of getting away from way to go, Ray, to you got to do this, Ray.
Well, yeah, I think they're stunned by what's happened here. Damiani has shown much better boxing skills than many thought he had, and Ray Mercer has not been able to, since that first round, to land anything of terrific note. Tentative. Ray's very, very tentative. Look, he's boxing. Now, that time, he was able to get that left hook in because he moved, but in general, that is not his game plan. That is not the way Ray Mercer wins box.
And it becomes apparent, too, that one punch isn't going to get Damiani out of there. It's not easy to say.
It's even harder for Ray Mercer to do. And the power edge we talked about with Ray Mercer, I think, gets minimized as this fight goes on. And as we see him pushing his punches, even all those gaps, there's nothing on those gaps. And he's also not following it. Whereas Damiani's jab, which we just saw, has a lot more sting to it.
A very good jab. And here again, I think it's worth mentioning that this does not appear to be a case of what Mercer isn't doing, it's what Damiani is doing.
Great, let him go. Great, step up.
Damiani is boxing superbly. Look at that. Superb combinations. And when Mercer's in this position, he can't land. And part of it is because he's so close to Damiani, it's not where Ray gets his best leverage.
Nice body shot by Damiani there with the right hand. And a glancing blow. I don't think that was a big shot at all. And Damiani goes down and has given no indication of getting up.
He got in the eye, I think. Wow. My goodness.
That's it. A huge cut. Broke his nose. I'm sure that's
from
what happened.
Nowhere.
Bleeding profusely from the nose. It was not a particularly big punch, I don't believe. It's just where it was, more than what it was. And the most dramatic turnaround I've seen in a long time.
Astonishing. Ray Mercer with a half uppercut, half hook. Knocking Damiani out at a moment when, for all the world, he looked to be in desperate trouble. It's been a night of some strange doings. This the strangest. You can theorize, and probably it's true, he simply broke his nose with that shot, and it simply was too painful for Francesco Damiani.
I'm sure that's exactly what happened. I don't profess to be a doctor, but in this case, I feel pretty certain that that's what happened.
Wow. I mean, that is as shocking as you can get in a boxing ring because of what had preceded it. You see the look on Ray Mercer's face when he went into what wasn't the neutral corner and had to run away. If you look at that nose, oh boy, yeah. Mercer was shocked. He thought to himself, wow.
Well, yeah, and it was a good punch, but it was not the kind of punch that puts a man down and out.
We don't think. I'm sure we'll see some of it. But the thing is that obviously it did damage, but no, it didn't look like it was the kind of punch that would knock Damiani. It looked like one that glanced by him almost, but clearly it did tremendous damage to his nose. And Damiani almost seemed resigned. He was in such pain and it was bleeding profusely. It was almost like he knew in his mind, I really can't go on, no matter how game I might be.
And the crowd is more stunned than anything else, too. That's the reaction. Bob Arum, I was watching Bob Arum in the ring. He was kind of slapping his head like, I don't believe this. He was almost like Jim Valvano when he won the final four.
Well, we're going to give you not one, not two, but three looks, ladies and gentlemen, to see if we can figure out exactly how this punch did the damage it did. Damiani throwing as he was and really being on the offensive. There's the punch.
It was a glancing punch.
Yes, but apparently it must have hit the nose just right to break it, or this probably will give us an even better look. Now here's the left hand. It will kind of come right across his face, or right on the tip of the nose. Oh, yeah. It just landed perfectly on the nose. Just perfectly. perfectly on that nose to break it, and that's what did it to Damiani. And we'll get another look, and you'll see it hit that nose in just the right spot, and enough to break it and cause the end of this fight, right on the tip of the nose. Not, there was an elbow in there also. Personally, I think it was probably the punch rather than the elbow.
Yeah, I think so too, and it was just in the right place. Look at the faces of the people at ringside.
Shocked. Completely shocked.
Something like ours, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
Tough way to lose for this man, and boy, did Ray Mercer dig down and find something. And a W, I guess, is a W. Here's Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Trump Taj Mahal referee Rudy battle reaches the count of 10. At 2 minutes, 47 seconds of the ninth round, the winner and new WBO heavyweight champion of the world, Merciless Ray Mercer. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a round of applause for a great effort by a great champion.
Well, I think the reaction here by everyone concerned continues to be shock, and I don't think anyone's more shocked than this man right here. Ray Mercer is a winner. We're going to have a chance to take another look at it. It isn't so much what the punch was, but where the punch was. And let's see if it was punch or elbow. We'll do a little analysis here. Here is the left hook. Uppercut, really. And the elbow comes back, but I still believe that it was the punch. You can judge. I believe it was the punch, not an elbow. And I believe it was, as Al Wesley mentioned, right on the tip of the nose. It was just in a place, and you could see it, almost a delayed reaction from Damiani. I don't think he realized he was as hurt as he was for an instant. And then went down and could not get up. And again, look at the crowd behind him. Incredulous look on the face of almost everyone here. Present company included.
Hey, Rudy, give me his hand.
And I think included in that man as well, as Ray Mercer has scored a victory, but it's a victory that will have both a period and a question mark after it. And he has thus run his record to 17-0, an extremely tough loss for Damiani. We're trying to get a hold of the officials' cards so that we can tell you exactly how this fight had gone up to this point. And we believe we'll be able to do that. Al Bernstein is amongst the maddening crowd and trying to get to Ray Mercer. And we'll take one more look before we go up to Al Bernstein. Let's take another look at that left hand and see what you think. I think it clearly was a punch. And it broke the nose of Damiani. Again, I don't profess to be a doctor. I'm not giving a medical opinion. But I think in this case, there's no question about it. Punch or elbow?
Hey, Mark.
I still believe it was a punch, but a little bit hard to tell. I don't really think that the elbow got to the nose, but it was a clean punch. And we're going to get a look at the scoring. And on the three judges' cards, and Al, I think you could probably hear me, Damiani was in front on all three judges' cards and in front big time on all of them. By 6 points on one card, 4 points on another, and 5 points on another. Damiani was winning the fight. Let's go up to Al Bernstein now, who is with the winner. Al?
All right, thank you, Barry. Ray, we can report to you. Now, first of all, congratulations on your win. We can report to you that you were way behind on all the judges' scorecard. I assume you knew that.
I think I did.
I guess you did. Were you surprised that that left hand got him out? It landed right on the point of the nose. When you threw it, did you see it hurt him right away?
Okay, first of all, I want to say hello to Connie, Kim, Tracy, and Lynn, my family, and Fort Huachuca. And thank Fort Huachuca for letting me train there. And all the guys in Desert Shield, this is for you, and this is the kind of determination it's going to take to win the battle, and we're going to do it.
All right, well, you did have determination, and you came back from big troubles. First of all, as I said, did you know that punch was hurt him right away?
I knew it landed, but I was trying to get room to throw combinations, and I just felt something just disappear in front of me. And he was down. Next thing you know, I looked down.
All right, what were your problems leading up to that round? Why couldn't you get off against him?
I think I was too hungry, and I was trying to land the hard shots to the body and all the hard shots when I should have been boxing, taking my time, and picking the punches.
All right, let's take a look at now where you landed the good left hand, the one that did him in, got you the WBO title, and shocked just about everybody, probably yourself a little.
Including me.
Yeah, let's including you. Let's take a look, Ray.
I knew I'd get in on it. I've been trying to throw the uppercut. I knew I can get in one time. I got in a couple of times, but it didn't faze me. That was just perfect. I didn't even feel it really on the end of my glove.
Is that right? You didn't even feel it. It was really a strong shot.
I didn't even feel it.
Did it land? I guess it landed right on the tip of the nose, broke his nose. Have you done that before?
No, this is my first time really hurting somebody, and it feels good. I'm the baddest man in the world, and I'd like to thank the Commission of New Jersey. They're the best, and without this, it wouldn't be possible.
We take a look. Now, tell us what exactly. You're coming through with the left hand here, Ray. How did you feel throwing this uppercut?
I felt very good. I knew I was landing the uppercut. We worked on the 45, and that's what it was, and it landed.
All right. You and the Triple Threat Enterprise people are happy about what happened, but what I have to ask this question. What can you do to correct the problems you had early in the match? I know you're celebrating, you're a champion, but that had to be a little dismaying to you.
Well, you know, I'm just like any other fighter out there, whether you're the champion or not. I'm still learning, and I'm just going back to the gym. We're going to work on a lot of things. I learned a lot from this fight, and thank God to Triple Threat Enterprise.
All right, Mark Roberts, what's next for your champion?
Well, first, I'd like to say that Ray, in 21 months of being a pro, has not only shown in every fight the determination, Odom, Cooper, and all those other fights coming up. He's learning more than any of these young guys who are fighting nobodies. None of these guys could have handled Damiani. We all know that. Ray is after Tyson, Holyfield, Foreman, Ruddick. Bring them on.
Right, who's next, though, for him, do you think?
Right now, we have a lot of alternatives after this fight for huge money. We're going to sit down. We're going to evaluate all of them. Ray Mercer is now in a position to fight for huge money, and that's what he's going to fight for. And we're going to go over all the options there. And Ray Mercer is truly a champion, and he showed that. And now, you have to realize, this is a man that only started boxing at the age of 24. This is a future man that the world will recognize as the baddest man on this planet.
All right, Ray, one thing that happened during this bout, Hank Johnson was telling you to jab and do the body work. You're having a hard time doing that a little bit early. Why was the body work so tough for you to get into?
Well, he had good defense. Like I said, you know, I'm still learning. I got to go back to the gym and work on a lot of things. I've just been boxing 2 years. I give myself a lot of credit. And thank God to Bob Arum. He's the best man beside my father.
Were you tired at all there or just frustrated?
No, I trained in Fort Huachuca, Arizona, the best straight to plane, trained. And I'm in tip-top shape. I just had to land the right punch.
Did you feel confident that you would get to him eventually?
I told Coach Jay, he's telling me throw more combinations. I was definitely going to work up throwing more combinations. I knew I would get to him. I had to, or I might as well just quit.
Was it frustrating, though, during those middle rounds?
Well, it was kind of tough. I was just trying to figure out a way that I could get in and try to land my punches. I tried a little lateral movement. I was just trying little things. We go back to the gym. We work on everything.
All right. Well, congratulations on winning your title, Ray. Ray Mercer does it in astonishing fashion, shocking fashion, he admitted, even to him. Let's go down to Barry Tompkins at ringside.
All right, thanks very much, Al. Well, as we mentioned, it was incredulous on everybody's face, including Ray Mercer, and he's the first one to admit it. So Ray Mercer nonetheless comes away with a win. In March, Top Rank will present another special pay-per-view event.
March 8th will be a night of brawling, featuring Carl the Truth Williams.
This is why I am the truth.
And Terrible Tim Witherspoon.
This is why they call me Terrible Tim.
Heavyweight brawlers Williams and Witherspoon fight for the USBA Championship. Top Rank presents Night of the Brawlers. Also featured cruiserweight champion Robert Daniels defending his WBA world title against Bobby Chaz, a former world light heavyweight champion. Daniels and Chaz for the WBA World Cruiserweight Championship. March 8th, Top Rank presents a fight night of brawling. See it live, pay-per-view. For information, contact your cable system.
Ray Mercer is the winner, and it falls into the category of who to thug it. It's been a bizarre night here tonight.
Strange indeed, but exciting. Nothing boring going on here, that's for sure. And this man put an exclamation point on the evening with a shot that I loved his candor. Even he admitted, I said it shocked everybody, and he said, even me.
Yeah, it did, because we said it seemed like a glancing blow. Well, it was where the blow was positioned. Matter of fact, that position where he hit it right on the tip of the nose, very dangerous. Mike Tyson always talks about that, kind of kids about that's where he tries to aim his punches. Well, that's where Ray Mercer hit it, and I talked to Rudy Badley, the referee in the fight, and he said it clearly broke Damiani's nose. There was no question about it.
We talk about the excitement of Ray Mercer. What about the disappointment of Damiani, who gave the performance of his life tonight until that happened?
And was ahead on every card. Let's take a look once again at the last round of this fight. Ray Mercer and Francesco Damiani. And again, we point out that Damiani was ahead, and ahead big time on all three of the officials' cards. Here are the final moments of this fight. Then this was early in the fight because remember, 9 seconds into this final round, what turned out to be the final round, tape came loose on Ray Mercer's gloves, and they had to go over Hank Johnson, you see, doing a little repair job. That was just 9 seconds into the fight. And then we got started once again. As you see, Rudy Battle taking a good long look at it.
And this little break might have even benefited Ray Mercer, because early on in the round there, getting a chance to compose himself, think things through yet again, and knowing full well that what would win this bout for him, and we said it during it, so it's not hindsight, would be one big punch. It's about all he had to possibly do in this bout. And of course, the reason why it seemed remote, and I think probably truthfully in his mind, I don't know that he was as confident as he would say they would get it, he was pushing his punches, he wasn't really landing with the leverage that he wanted. And this round was really not that much different than the others.
No.
There was no clue here that this was going to happen.
None whatsoever. That's what accounted, I think, for the expression on the faces of everybody who was watching it, including the man who delivered it, including the man who went down from it.
That's true. Damiani still working the body and shooting his little uppercuts and basically beating Mercer to the punch. It had been this way over all the rounds, with the possible exception of the first round. And I have to tell you, Hank Johnson said to me leaving the ring, he said, Damiani's a much better fighter than I thought he was.
Yeah, me too.
And me three.
Yeah, Damiani really showed very well. And now we talked earlier about the fact that every heavyweight in America who's up amongst the elite is going to want to fight Damiani, and I think that's going to happen again. Damiani's going to get a lot of fights and a lot of paydays out of this.
I think he will, and I have to be truthful. A lot of people might want to fight Ray Mercer, too.
Yeah, I think that's true.
He knocked Damiani out. They see some of the things Damiani did to exploit him, and Ray candid in admitting, as was his manager, that he's still learning. They feel he's going to be, as they said in quotes, the baddest man on the planet, but he might not be quite yet.
Oh, and that's the thing. Now you have to ask yourself, because Mark Roberts saying to you, there's big money fights and all that kind of thing, but there's one school of thought that says it might have been pushing him even to take him as far as this fight tonight, and he was losing this fight. Now, how much further do you push him?
And let's think to ourselves, we saw Bruce Seldon tonight. There's lots of talk of him as a future opponent for Ray Mercer. That's a war.
Yeah.
Could be an interesting bout.
Bruce Seldon with the great hand speed as well.
Yeah. Now, there Ray Mercer doing what he wanted to do throughout most of this fight, landing a couple jabs and straight right hand. And in looking at this round in retrospect, it does look very similar to the other round.
Getting down to the point now where Ray Mercer will come up with that sort of half hook, half uppercut. And there it was. And even then, it looked like a glancing blow.
Fascinating. You have to see that in slow motion to know where it landed. You see when he gets up, the blood is flowing from his nose and blood all over his legs. And you know that this is a serious injury. This is not a man that quits. I mean, Damiani's been nailed with some shots and has not quit. And the celebration begins. And you know what? Bob Aramone's got knocked out in that celebration.
Yeah, he did. That's what I was saying earlier. I haven't seen anybody in a place like that in a moment like that since Jim Valvano won the Final Four,
right,
looking around for somebody to hug. And Akbar Muhammad already had Ray Mercer.
He
there was
always
nobody.
Finds someone to hug.
So Ray Mercer comes away with a win. And to look back on the rest of the card that we saw tonight, because remember, we started this program by saying these fighters not only have to win, but have to win impressively. Tommy Morrison certainly did that. Bruce Seldon certainly did that. And I don't know what you can say about the main event.
Well, the main event was a situation in which Ray Mercer may have those problems he had early may set up even more for him in the way of opponents, because now people might look at those first two guys and think they weren't ready before. Maybe they're ready.
So Ray Mercer is a winner. He is now 17-0, and he takes the next logical step, whatever logic dictates. As for the man he beat, he's going to go on and have more fights, too. Bruce Seldon certainly will take a big step up. He defeated Jose Ribalta in impressive fashion tonight, a TKO. At the end of round number three, Ribalta could not continue any further. And then it was Tommy Morrison who was a most impressive win over James Quick Tillis, who wasn't. But nonetheless, it was more a case of what Morrison did rather than what Quick Tillis didn't. And that's always the story, of course, in boxing. We've talked about that ad nauseum. But that only took a minute and 51 seconds of round number one for Tommy Morrison to take, I think, a pretty good stride for him, coming back, shaking off a little ring rust after he had the movie-making experience. So now he's back as a full-time boxer and looks all the bit the part of a future champion. Ray Mercer, he beats Damiani in round nine, but I think it could be for him a case of back to the old drawing board.
It really is, and you don't like to be saying that to a guy that just won the WBO, but I'll tell you what, Ray Mercer got it here.